What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In today's video, we're going to dive into what Jenkins is and see how it improves our DevOps continuous integration environment. Now, before doing that, let's look at what developers used to do prior to Jenkins. A common scenario would be to have some code written by the developers. This code would then be submitted into a code repository, and hopefully unit tests would have been attached to this code and run by the devs. You see, the problem with that approach is that the actual commits that get sent to the code repository are inconsistent, as we might have a dozen developers all committing to the same repository at different times. At this point, we will have to wait for all developments to be integrated and for the project to be built to then start the live testing and notify the devs if bugs were found. And if something goes wrong, we will end up with a bunch of developers pointing fingers and blaming each other, leading to a huge increase in the project's finalization and bug fixing processes. Because of this, nightly builds were born. So, one thing we used to do is commit changes to the source code repository during the day, then the developers would all have a cutoff time at the end of the day to stop committing. At night, all that code would be operated and tested, and a new build would be created, and that would be referred to as the nightly build. Then, at a later stage, this build could be released into production manually or via automated processes. But you see, with continuous integration, we're able to not only commit our changes into our source code, but we can do this continuously. There's no need to set an arbitrary cutoff time. The concept of continuous integration is that as developers, we're able to pull from a repository the code that we're working on, and then at any time submit that code into a continuous integration server. And the goal of that continuous integration server is to validate the build and run any tests that a tester may have created. If on the continuous integration server a test isn't passed, then that code gets sent back to the developer and the developer can make the changes it needs. The code isn't committed and the main repo source is not impacted. This allows the developer to not break the build, maintaining a green status, and it also spares devs the need to run all the tests locally on their computer. Finally, we can choose to release this build, and by applying the same thought process, we can automate the release and tap into CD or continuous deployment. The goal of doing all this is that now we're able to release and deploy continuously and that our customers can get new code faster, code that is guaranteed to work. Now, to achieve everything we just covered, we will need help. Help provided by certain tools, and there is a wide range of open source and private CI tools we can pick from. For example, Bamboo is a continuous integration tool that specifically runs multiple builds in parallel for faster compilation. It has integration with Ant, Maven, and other similar tools. If we're working specifically on Java projects that need to be built and tested, then Apache Gump is the top choice. It makes sure that all the projects are compatible at both API and functionality levels. BuildBot is a tool that allows us to automate the software build, test, and release process. It is written in Python and supports parallel execution jobs across multiple platforms. One of the most popular places to store code and create versioning for it is GitHub. And if our code is on GitHub, then we'll be able to use Travis CI. It's a tool designed specifically for GitHub-hosted projects and supports over 20 languages. And finally, there's Jenkins. Jenkins is an open source automation tool for all projects, and it is comprised of four key areas. Easy installation. Jenkins is a self-contained Java program that allows it to run on most of the popular operating systems. Easy configuration. The web interface makes it very easy to check for errors, and additionally, we have great built-in help. Extensibility via plugins. One of the things that makes tools like Jenkins powerful for developers and DevOps teams are plugins. Jenkins has hundreds of plugins in its update center that can be used to configure and extend it to fit our environment. Distributed. Now, remember that extending Jenkins does not mean creating a custom version of Jenkins, and that's important because the core foundation of the Jenkins product remains the same, which means that our extensions mature with new releases, making it easier to have them available across the entire network. Okay, let's dive into the standard Jenkins pipeline. So, we always start with the development, the coding, and the first thing we must do in a Jenkins pipeline is pull the committed code. Jenkins will then create a build of our code, and part of that build process is going through and running tests. Again, we're already comfortable with running unit tests and writing those tests, but there may be additional tests that Jenkins is running. For instance, as a team, we may have a standard set of tests for how we write code so that each team member can understand what's being written. Those tests can also be included in the testing process within the Jenkins environment. Assuming everything passed, we can now release these developments into a ready or development environment within Jenkins. We can spend as much time as we like playing around with that version, and finally, when we are ready, we can deploy the code to a production environment. Jenkins will help us deploy our code to the production environment, making the move from a development to production code a very fast process. This whole process can be automated rather than having to wait for people to test the code or go through a nightly build. We are now able to commit code and go through this testing and release process continuously. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like a follow-up video in which we talk about the underlying Jenkins architecture and/or attempt to set up Jenkins and use it alongside our Spring Boot project. So that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.